Okay, so now let's have a look at details of engine. We'll look at different components used in engine. So first, here you can see a crankshaft. Here this black shaft in this figure is considered as crankshaft. On that crankshaft, one link is mounted, okay, with pin joint, you can say. Or you can say rigid joint. Okay. This link is called crank. In this figure, this black portion over here is crank. From center to this point, it is known as crank radius, this portion. And below that point, some more weight, more amount of weight is present, that is called counterweight. And another end of crank is connected with connecting rod through pin joint. In this figure, this link over here is called connecting rod, whose bottom end is large as compared to top end. Here a larger bearing will be present and here smaller bearing will be present. Okay, so larger end of connecting rod is connected to crank with pin joint. Connecting rod is connected with piston. This connecting rod is connected with piston again through pin joint. This pin over here is called gudgeon pin or piston pin. And this whole assembly is encased, is enclosed. And this portion, this topmost portion of this casing, from this point to this point is called cylinder. And bottom portion below this point is called as sump or crank case, you can say. Sump or crank case. And above this point, this upper portion is called cylinder head. Cylinder head will have opening for inlet and exhaust gases and opening for valves as well as spark plug for petrol engine and fuel plug for diesel engine. So this much opening, these many openings are present in cylinder head. So this mechanism over here is basically a valve operating mechanism. How these valves will open and close automatically based on position of piston. So here many arrangements are possible. Here gear arrangement is shown. So this crankshaft, on this crankshaft a smaller gear is mounted and this gear is in mesh with another gear, and this gear is connected with this camshaft. Okay, this shaft is known as camshaft. On this camshaft, two cams are present and these cams are in contact with these rods, vertical rods, also known as push rods. And these push rods are in connection with this lever mechanism over here. And at the other end of the lever, valves are present. So according to rotation of this crankshaft, this camshaft will rotate. And according to position of this cam, this push rod will move up and down. And this up and down movement will be transferred to these valves through this lever mechanism. So let's take up each components one by one. So first one is cylinder. Cylinder is basically a heart of engine in which fuel is burnt and power is developed. Okay. So fuel will be burnt inside cylinder and power will be developed. So cylinder has to withstand very high pressure and temperature, because some combustion of fuel is carried out within cylinder. therefore cylinder must be cooled. Okay, in bikes it will be cooled with air, in heavy automobiles it will be cooled with water. The inside diameter of cylinder is called bore, and the piston reciprocates inside the cylinder. The inside diameter of the cylinder is called bore. Inside diameter, this diameter of cylinder is called bore. Theoretically, the inside diameter of cylinder and diameter of piston is same, theoretically. But in actual practice, there will be a slight difference. Theoretically, it is same. Next, cylinder head. So, cylinder head covers top end of cylinder. It provides space for valve mechanisms, spark plug, and fuel injector, etc. Figure shown here is a cylinder head of heavy automobile, in which here you can see four ports are given. Okay, this is exhaust port. These four ports you can see over here is for valve, and this is for inlet of fuel, and on the other side for exhaust of exhaust gases. Okay, this hole here in middle is provided for spark plug in spark ignition engine, and for fuel injector for diesel engine. This I am talking about, this middle hole. And next component is piston. Piston is basically a close fitting hollow cylindrical plunger reciprocating inside the cylinder. The power developed by the combustion of fuel is transmitted by the piston to the crankshaft through connecting rod. Okay. In this figure we can see the combustion of fuel will take place over here. The thermal energy will be generated, high pressure and temperature condition will be generated over here. So due to that high pressure, this piston will move downward, and this downward movement of piston will be converted into rotational motion of this crankshaft through this connecting rod and crank. Piston will transfer the force on connecting rod, connecting rod will transfer the force on crank, so crank will rotate. So this motion will be transferred to crankshaft, the crankshaft will rotate. So piston will look like this. It is basically a hollow plunger. Okay. And on top of piston, these three slots are provided. What is the purpose? We will discuss later on. Okay. So it is basically a hollow plunger, and this hole here provided is for pin joint. So next is piston ring. The piston rings are the metallic rings inserted into the circumferential grooves provided at the top end of the piston. Okay. Piston rings will be assembled in these grooves. Okay. In these grooves present on the piston. Okay. These rings maintain a gas tight joint between the piston and the cylinder while the piston is reciprocating inside the cylinder. So as I said, theoretically the diameter of piston and internal diameter of cylinder is same, but in actual practice there must be some gap so that relative motion can be possible. Okay, so there may be chances that this high pressure gas can penetrate in this crankcase and deteriorate the condition of lubricant. So to avoid transfer of high pressure temperature gases to bottom, or avoid the transfer of lubricants from bottom to top, we are placing piston rings in between these. So piston ring will act as a separator between top chamber and bottom chamber. It will provide a gas tight joint between piston and cylinder while the piston is reciprocating in the cylinder. Next component is piston pin or gudgeon pin. As I said, it is just provided, it acts as a pin joint, and it is present between piston and connecting rod. This is made of steel by forging process. Next is connecting rod. Connecting rod basically is a member connecting piston through pin and crankshaft through crank pin. It converts reciprocating motion of the piston into rotary motion of crankshaft. Okay. This component is called connecting rod. Okay. This larger end is connected with crank and this smaller end is connected with piston. Both ends are connected through pin joint. Okay. Pin joint connection will be there. Okay. So this component is responsible for converting reciprocating motion of piston into rotary motion of crankshaft. Next is crank and crankshaft. The crank is a lever that is connected to the big end of the connecting rod by a pin joint with its other end connected rigidly to a shaft called crankshaft. It rotates about the axis of the crankshaft and causes the connecting rod to oscillate. As I showed in last figure, this component is called crank and the shaft is called crankshaft. This crankshaft is for single cylinder engine, for bikes, and this shaft is for multi-cylinder engines in cars or heavy automobiles. The big end of the connecting rod is connected over here to pin joint. Next component is valves. So engines have both intake and exhaust type of valves, which are operated by the valve opening mechanism. As I showed in detailed figure, that these valves are operated through camshaft, pushrod and lever mechanism. The valves are the devices which controls the flow of the intake and exhaust gases. So these valves are responsible for flow of fuel inside the cylinder and flow of exhaust gases outside the cylinder. It will look like this. Next component is a flywheel. Flywheel is basically a heavy wheel mounted on the crankshaft of the engine. It minimizes cyclic variation in speed by storing the energy during power stroke, and the same is released during the other stroke. So flywheel is basically a heavy wheel mounted on crankshaft. Let's see it in figure. Okay, so flywheel will be mounted on crankshaft. It will be mounted over here, a wheel whose purpose is to store the excess energy and give back that energy when requirement arises. So we'll see that in detail while discussing 4-stroke and 2-stroke engine, how flywheel works. Just keep this in mind that its purpose is to minimize the cyclic variation in speed. Okay, next component is crankcase. It is the lower part of the engine serving as an enclosure of the crankshaft and also as a sump for the lubricating oil. let's look at in this figure, the portion below the cylinder. In this figure, the portion below this point is called crankcase or sump. It will act as a reservoir for lubricant. Okay. Oil. In everyone refills oil in their bike. Okay, so that oil goes into this region. It will be used for lubricating these joints as well as whatever bearings will be present over here. It will act as lubrication. So to store that oil, this casing is created, whose name is crankcase or sump. Next component is carburetor. Carburetor is used in petrol engine for proper mixing of air and petrol. So basically in petrol engines, first we are mixing air and petrol, then we are sending this mixture into cylinder, then we are igniting that mixture. So to form a correct mixture of air and petrol, a device used is called carburetor. It will be only used in petrol engine. Fuel pump. Okay. So in diesel engine, fuel pumps will be used. In operation of diesel engine, we are first taking air inside the cylinder and then we are compressing that air so that its temperature increases. We are increasing the temperature of air such that as soon as the diesel comes into contact with that air, it burns. Okay, so fuel pump is used to insert the fuel inside the cylinder in diesel engine. Fuel pump is used in diesel engines only for increasing pressure and controlling the quantity of fuel supplied to the injector. And fuel injector. Fuel injector is used to inject the diesel fuel in the form of fine atomized spray under pressure at the end of compression stroke. Okay. We are converting the diesel and diesel fuel into small atomized spray so that efficient burning can take place. Next component is spark plug. It will be used only in petrol engine. Okay, spark plug is used in petrol engine to produce a high intensity of spark for ignition of air fuel mixture in cylinder. Okay. We are producing spark in this space over here to burn the air and fuel petrol mixture. So let's take a look at assembly. First crankshaft, crank, on that crank connecting rod is mounted. On the upper end of connecting rod, piston is assembled, and to connect piston with connecting rod, this piston pin or gudgeon pin is used. And we have shown here gear mechanism to operate the valve. Okay, so these gears are in mesh, and on this gear and shaft is attached. It's called cam shaft, and these are the cams. You can see only in some portion it is having extruded part. Okay. And these cams are in contact with these push rods, and these push rods are connected with valves through lever mechanism. And here we can see the working of the engine and how valves are operated. You can see this up and down movement of piston is converted into rotary motion of this crank because of connecting rod. Okay. And this rotating motion of crankshaft is transferred to camshaft. So cams will rotate, and because of rotation of cam, because of profile of cam, these rods will have up and down movement, and these up and down movement of push rod is transferred to valves through this lever mechanism. That cam profile, so you can better understand the operation of cam. The cam is having this kind of shape, and this here white portion in middle is the shaft called camshaft, and this rod you can consider it as push rod. So as soon as the cam rotates, because of this kind of shape, the rotational movement of cam is converted into reciprocating movement of push rod. You can see over here.